Eloy, what am I doing? I'm talking to 4,000 people. Firstly, I just want to say, if you guys are watching this video, thank God, finally, our 14 days program that we have been waiting for months is finally and officially here. And as you guys can see, I'm all rigged up for this. This is the most exciting moment in my life. And I just want to thank you, because for without you guys, there won't be me. And when there's no me, there's no this. So, welcome to the 14 days program whereby you guys get to sit down and experience every single bit of the perspective of how I do what I do. So a short introduction for those of you that are new here. If you guys do not know who I am, I've gone by many names. When I began, I was known as Dika, and then I grew into Mr. Wicks, and then I became this my final ultra alter ego, Mr. Black Sheep. And through Mr. Black Sheep was when we managed to break the skies. That was the side of me whereby I wanted to show the world, if you guys are truly the black sheep of the world, you can fucking do it. And all it takes is just perseverance, repetition, consistency, and ultra precision. But Mr. Black Sheep was not the final character, as I feel, because I think I deserve to tell you guys what is happening. So, from today onwards, it is sad to inform, but it is what it is. Mr. Black Sheep is dead, and here I am, and I'll be going on moving forward as Mr. Cloud. For Mr. Black Sheep, Mr. Weeks, Mr. Dika, they were all my alter ego. They were a part of me. They were subcomponents of me, especially as a trader. And for every each different individual character I was carrying, there was a uniqueness towards them. But after building a community of 4,000 people across the world, especially India, Pakistan, Brunei, Singapore, United Kingdoms, where else? Indonesia, Vietnam, Philippines, Thailand, Malaysia, and the list goes on. Latin America, Mexico. It's insane. I'm just a 27-year-old boy, wanted to become a streamer back in the day, but was just too suckish at fucking gaming, and somehow found a passion in live trading, and suddenly I just managed to get traction. And through this traction, people have witnessed insanity. So, as the first day of our 14 days program, there is actually one component whereby I want to touch before we even begin to go diving deep in the world of the engulfing theory, the technical analysis, the trade execution, the M1, M5 continuation and confirmation entries. There is just one thing whereby you guys have to listen to this. This particular component in life, you can call me superstitious or what, but it is my founding root, and without this element that I truly hold on to my life, there's no way I can do what I do. Because for those of you that do not know, I like to give signals and I like to go live trading. I have showcased 2,000 to 24,000 in a month, live, updated every single day. I have showed you $1 million account that was flipped from $500,000. I have showed you $2,000 flipped till $15,000. And the crazy part is, those were all just from Mr. Black Sheep. You guys have not seen the insanity of Mr. Wicks. Live trade NFP, $1,000 flip till $8,000. People were there, they saw it. And that is how I became who I am and known for. I'm the best in the game. So, after achieving massive success in this particular industry, I would say, of course, success to me is addictive. And after growing a fond to the community, especially if you guys know how close I am to them, I have established this deep internal connection whereby they no longer are strangers to me. They are people who I can sort of consider as a family. And I've told them once I was going to leave in April, and I was going to leave in April because I told them as well, usually at the first quarter of the year, I'll be making enough money to sustain me for the next year. But here's the thing. I did not know of my own potential, and I've never thought I would become who I am right now, especially in the perspective of a market leader. So just to go into a backtrack of things, I grew a brand literally out of 12,000 community members only, and I climbed the ranks of Okta. I became number 2, and from there, Black Sheep was a serious movement. And to throw all this away for just lively pleasure was like a waste. And that was when I came up with the idea. For I will put an end to Mr. Black Sheep because he has showcased all the greatness that was needed in a trader. Now, Mr. Cloud is the guy that is gonna make you become like a Mr. Black Sheep. This is the time whereby you will see and perceive me as your teacher, your guidance, your brother, your knowledgeable friend, or whatever it may be, but just know I'm not your Sifu. And from here, my goal is to climb in a rank whereby people around me become as successful as me. So welcome everybody to the 14 days program whereby I will change your life, and like you guys know, when I say something, I will achieve it no matter what. So, what are we gonna be talking about today? And this is whereby I feel if you do not understand and you do not really take this deeply, the Forex journey or any trading journey, regardless, crypto, stock markets, Forex, whatever it may be, if there's a buy or sell button and you do not have this part of you sorted, you are not gonna succeed, believe me. So, the number one issue that you guys seem to not understand is how money works in life. Money is literally a representation of how your internal being is doing or is at. So therefore, you can see sometimes money can come easily to some and can become very hard for others. But what and why is that? So, this is a personal experience I've witnessed, and I have always documented when it comes to my financial growth. If you do not have your internal being, your soul sorted out, your life, your relationships, your past traumas, if these aspects are not conquered and dealt with, you can rest assured the reflection, the chaos from within will be reflected out into this world. Then you will start to see your relationships, your friendships, your family, your trauma are all on an insane level. And as well as your financial level. So this is whereby, in the end guys, the prosperity that you will enjoy from the market really is dictated upon how blessed are you by the universe, how blessed are you by God. Because as beautiful as it is a $6.6 trillion market. So for us to understand the capacity of potential profit and income that can flow through us and into us is immense. But if you treat your human life as a vessel, your human body as a vessel, are you confident you are worthy of such amounts to begin with? So, this is whereby you have to start and take control of your life. No matter how tough it is, no matter how disastrous it is, there is no way out. You can be a pussycat doll about it. You can be a baboon complaining, feeling like dying. No one gives a shit. And when I say no one, I literally mean no one gives a fucking shit. But if you do not take into consideration and make the matter as an urgent matter to be dealt with, you are gonna be stuck in that environment for such a long time. And believe me, no matter what technique, no matter what indicators, robots, how many amount of money you can deposit, it does not matter, because the market will be used to take back what you do not deserve in life. So if you are not a blessed person, if you are a person who does a lot of stupid shit in your life. You take from people, you steal from people, you scam people, you owe people money, you do not provide for your family. I recommend you to just stay away from the market, because if you believe in karma or whatever it may be, the market will be used as a medium to suck your fucking money out. So that's when you guys have to understand how money works. Money only stays for those who deserve, and for those who deserve are those who give. So start giving in your life first, then you will be receiving from the market. For if not, even with the best signal, you will somehow lose. It is what it is, and you guys have to agree. I assure you, many of you are experiencing this right now. So that is number one. So knowing that fact, go sort that out. Number two, this is my secret sauce. And I was contemplating whether or not to share this particular segment, but why not? Like I said, this is Superstitious Part 2. So do not have an open mind regarding it, because I swear to God, it will have and it will contain so much value if you actually are able to implement it in your life. So it goes like this. First is, you have to understand the capacity of your human brains. So this is whereby I was really interested with one particular case study / scientific report that I have obtained. It is called the Silva method. So the Silva method is basically, for me, if I were to shut it down for you, you guys can go search that up yourself, okay? But it talks about the brainwave and the brain activity, about the alpha, theta, state of mind and all that sort. So this guy was a particular dude that is a radio man. So he deals a lot around waves. And one day, basically, to cut story short, he felt like he wanted to test out on his kids whether if he can help improve the rate and grades of his kid through certain mental training that will make the brain so fucking efficient that it can obtain information without knowing where the information is coming from. This is very important, and this is very, very important. So listen up. One thing was clear was the way he conducted the experiment was he would give out questions to the kid, for example, history, and he'll ask, for example, who was the 16th president of the United States and all that. And he'll make the daughter answer back and forth, back and forth. But if let's say the daughter doesn't know, then he teaches the answer. But the amazing part was it came to a point whereby at one point he literally had the question in his mind was, who was the 16th president of America? But as he was formulating the question in his mind, the child answered and he was shocked. Okay, why I'm referring to this particular case study is because he has it down into words that I cannot describe by myself. For example, the most frequent statements I get about me as a trader especially is, Mr. Black Sheep, Mr. Cloud, how do you know that is the right time to press? Because when you give out a signal, in less than 2 minutes, it fucking explodes. You want to know how I do it, right? So like I said, this 14 days is for me to literally share every component that I use. So you can take it or you can call me, this is some voodoo shaman shit. I don't care. But this thing exists. So going from that, he basically discovered if you can put your mind in a certain state, you will receive an organic biofeedback from whatever you want to call it, the universe, your brain, your subconscious. Because basically to him, information is energy. Energy is traveling in the form of radiation, waves and stuff like that. So if you can bring your brain to a certain frequency level, specifically the alpha state of mind, you will be able to access into the universal information. Somehow you will see, or I believe you have experienced this in your life. Sometimes you know things that you do not know how you know, but you just know. And it's true and it's right after you go through the whole incident. So this is what it's all about. That's why I always tell you guys, patience is number one. Keeping yourself calm is number two. Because in a state of peace, your brain will be able to access this alpha state of mind, and hence you will see your intuition, your general biofeedback will kick in, and the more you practice it and the sharper you become with it, you can start to trust your intuition very well. And you know whether or not this intuition is a direct true information or this is just emotions. This is where you guys have to be at a certain point. Like I said, you can believe me if you want to, but it is what it is. Because I can assure you that some of you at home will be like, oh motherfucker, what the fuck is he talking about? Like, this is some crazy ass shit. Do not doubt and never fucking doubt your human mind. It is so powerful. You'll be surprised how underutilized it actually is. So, that is the theoretical aspect of things. And hence, if you truly want to become like me, then you have to know the mantras and the rituals in order to be able to maintain in the alpha state of mind. That's why I said, whatever you have in your personal life that is causing you chaos, destruction, depression, anger, issues with your parents, family, siblings, kids, whatever it may be, your boss, your job, your financial status, your loans, sort that out first. That I cannot help. So that's why you guys can see the rich gets richer, the poorer gets poorer. Because the rich always surrounds themselves in the positive environment, and the poor is always somehow stuck in this toxicity, vicious cycle of environment. Deal with your internal state of being and you will see the things surrounding you will change. And this is fact. Do it first and then let me know how it goes. So if, for example, you have done that aspect of things, meaning you have sought that out, you are finally able to say, Mr. Cloud, I'm in the best state of mind right now. I'm in peace. Okay, then now I will teach you the first topic of the 14 days program. And it is called mental journaling. Because why is mental journaling the most important thing you need to do in terms of a trader, especially if you are trading every day? Mental journaling will be able and will subconsciously put your mind at ease. It will soothen the anxiety. It will soothen the nervousness. It will soothen the excitement because you are re-educating yourself through your journaling. But we are living in the modern world. Everything is going fast. And definitely, writing on a book is not our thing. So, this is how I do it all the time. And this is how you must do it for the next coming 14 days. Because even if you do not know what you're doing, the act of doing it will put you at ease. So, this is whereby the practice comes. And I will go into the iPad right now. Okay, so now, let's go on about how do we do mental journaling and why is it important. I repeat again, in order for you to be able to be successful almost all the time, is that when you take your trades, it has to be from a very peaceful state of mind. If you don't do so, you guys are gonna get fucked. Believe me. So, I believe it's best if I show you how to specifically do it so that you will be able to replicate my mantra. So, firstly, we begin with mapping out our zones for the day. Okay, I'm not going to teach you guys how to mark specifically because I have provided 3 videos on my YouTube channel that has that. Please go check that out. And today and onwards is going to be mostly how do we execute practically so that you guys can observe my way of thinking each and every time we are in different range of daily zones and weekly zones. Okay, so now, the week just opened and hence we have to first understand what just happened and what can potentially happen. So for this particular case we are in, it's very straightforward, whereby gold is currently in a weekly sell trend. Remember, for those of you that do not know, all of us in the 1% society managed to get the sell over here, over here, over here, and they have witnessed I flipped 2,000 to around 16,000 US dollars in less than 8 days, just from understanding the potential sell. So we are anticipating this thing to happen and we have expected it. Hence, this is no shock. And as a trader, it's best to always start from the weekly time frame, simply because you are trying to obtain a trade that contains big money. And to showcase to you, let's say if you guys are a billionaire. A billionaire does not do their investment every monthly basis from a point of view. They would generally go on about how many percent of gains they can manage to get in, let's say, a year, 5 years, 10 years. That's how their projection is. So when they project or they do their analysis, majority and mainly of the time is going to be from the bigger time frame. So to safeguard our tiny ass account in a $6.6 trillion market, it's recommended to try our best to obtain a same level playing field so that we play with them, not against them. So that's why weekly is a very good start point when you want to start mapping. So my style of mapping is I do not go too far from my current zone. As to me, the fresher the price is, the more responsive you could be. But that's not saying that historical price do not carry any weight. Hence, for me, like I always tell you guys, I will always try to locate whether an engulfing buy or an engulfing fail to begin with. So as we guys can see here, this is an engulfing sell fail. It was an engulfing sell zone that was broken, and hence leaving it as a room for a potential future buy. And at the same time, in this particular zone, there was another engulfing sell down below that was also broken by the buyers. So from this perspective, I can anticipate in the range of 1867 down till 1812, I can potentially find a very strong group of buying price. Hence, I can lower my risk and my trade in terms of its success. So that's why I said, do not trade until we are out of the prostitute zone. The prostitute zone was the daily zone from here. And hence, I have told you guys about the drama. No, not here. Here specifically. I've told you guys about the potential drama that this zone can give. Simply because if you guys look at historical price proof, this zone was not a zone that had many, I would say, time to battle in the market. This particular blue range of zone happened very quickly every time prices came to enter. So therefore, it shows that in a general macro perspective, that small range of price is not what is enticing to the whole global market. Hence, you will see it will do crazy shit in here. Meaning, this is why I call it a prostitute zone. It is a zone that has been poked so many times that it is hollow. So from this hollow zone, we will expect a clear burst either up or down, which I've mentioned. Hence, if we don't trade out of this zone, and let's say we take a wrong trade, and at that wrong trade, we decided to be the Casino Royale, opening our SLs, layering, trying to expect for bigger reversals, so we keep adding more layers, and hence kaboom, our account blown. Not understanding, once the movement has been decided in this zone, it can whack in one direction without stop. So therefore, as a tiny account, that's why I've told you guys, we are not trading this zone. For whatever, when it is in the zone, no signal was given. And look at how beautifully we have saved our account, whereby others, when they try to buy and sell in here, they're gonna get wrecked. and there's no way out of that situation now for them. So, moving on. After selecting our zone, from the weekly perspective, the purple zone that is, I will filter down into the daily zone, whereby I want to know at which price range did it give the most powerful burst, and at the same time, at which particular price range it has a potential strong reversal. Because if we want to take a trade, we must make sure our trade can at least give us 60 pips. And it would be optimum if we can get a 100 to 120 pips direction of a reversal, maybe H4. Because from there, we can potentially add more layers, number one. Second is, even if we had to float, the potential of recovering the float is quite certain. So that kind of zones will definitely be in our favor to win against the market. So in order for those zones to happen, it has to have the same correlation from the lower time frame in here. So let's say now we're in daily. So in this purple zone, we are anticipating a buy, correct? Hence, we wait at zones whereby it could give us a buy. We don't try to be the motherfucker that tries to sell before the buy. Because the buy is the plan. The sell is an unplanned. Because at any point in here, it wouldn't be shocking if it starts to reject. To go where? Retest its previous breakout at the 194 range. You think it's impossible, but this is gold, baby. 400-500 pips is nothing. So stick to the plan. If you guys want to be like me, this is how I always do it. And that's why you guys know I'm not a high quantity signal provider. I'm a low quantity but high pips. So from there, in a win to lose ratio, we can always come out winning, because our take profit is a 1-to-1 ratio with our stop loss. So to recover our stop loss is very easy with our strategy. That's the plan. So as a trader, you have to have a plan. So now the plan is to look for a zone that can give us a strong buy first. So this kind of zones, there are attributes whereby we have to know when we want to pick out our daily engulfing zones. So number one, I want to make sure the zones that I pick has historical proof whereby price was aggressive when it's in the zone. So meaning, I want to find a place whereby there was many engulfing buy and sells formed. I don't care the direction, I care about how many times it's formed. The more times it formed means there's a high intensity of battle in the market in that price range. Because engulfing buys shows a potential reversal in direction. And engulfing sells shows a potential reversal in direction. So when we have a lot of those happening in the same equal price level, we are going to potentially increase our odds of winning. Correct? So therefore, as we can see here, engulfing sell, engulfing sell, engulfing buy, engulfing buy, engulfing buy, engulfing buy, engulfing sell. So there's a lot over here. Engulfing sell, break, fly. So as I can see it, this particular range of price is going to give us a more solid potential profit rather than fighting for a buy over here. But we cannot miss out on potentials, because in the end, there can be prices that is not in this high quality zone that can give us the same pips. So where do we look for it? So this is where we go into the characteristic of the particular movement. As we guys can see here, this was an engulfing sell. So technically, for a period of time from when it was here until here, it gave us a resistance zone. After the resistance zone was broken, it formed an engulfing buy. It broke out from here, fucking what, 1000 pips more, to be honest. 1600 pips maybe. So So we cannot avoid. What if even just 30% of the previous buyers entered somewhere here? That's where we will get fucked if we try to sell. You get me? Because in the end, as a small trader, we don't have 1 million, 10 million dollar accounts. We are like 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 500, maybe some 50. So we have to be very selective because we can't be demanding. We don't have much to offer, but we're trying to take as much as we can from the market. So there is another one over here whereby this guy flew 1,600 pips. And at the same time, there was an engulfing sell here that was broken. So I will take the combination of these two price range. And monitor this area. No, let me change the color. So that's why color coordination is very important. If you have a messy chart, you're going to be very anxious because you do not know what to do when it arrives. Okay, so this green area now is on the daily. So I will then filter again within that zone. So do you see the process? So I'll go to H4. In H4, I will go to the area I was talking about and I will see where was the potential bias that kicked in usually. So it's around the lower region over here. So therefore, I just have to minimize my zone to get it at a place whereby a lot of engulfing buy and engulfing sell happen. So as you guys can see, do you see how many engulfing buys and sell that happens in that green zone? So this price range, I'll be monitoring. So let me get a color. So now tell me, how do you guys expect to be profitable? Because I know 90% of you just opens the fucking phone, tries to wait for a signal that is sent out on in Telegram. Whoever you may follow, that's not the problem, but the attitude is the problem. So I will wait here. No matter what, the rain or shine, if it starts flying over here, I'm not even going to be bothered. My first zone. My second zone is the one lower here in the blue box for the buy. So I've gotten two zones. Every day, you don't need to have 10 zones. You just have to have two zones below, two zones above. You will see your profit can be immense. Because these zones are what we classify as low risk. So low risk zones can be used as a potential recovery zone. You get me? You try to scalp over here. Suddenly things go haywire. You cut loss. And then if you do not know where to press next, you're going to start pressing aggressively because you're emotional. So let's say if you make a mistake when you're not in a zone, that's fine. Wait for the zone to recover for you. That is how powerful my engulfing theory is. So once we have gotten this and this, we chill for the buy over here. Don't bother to go elsewhere. For the sell, this is where we just have to go and see. For example, this is an engulfing buy zone. Okay, because this is the nearest zone to the price range now. We can go up here, but there's no point. So we go here first. This engulfing buy zone is potentially going to be broken. Confirm. So if it's broken, if we know that this zone can be a failed zone, meaning it failed its job as an engulfing buy zone, which is a buy movement. So now it can be used as a sell movement. So where do I want to take from here? Simply over here. I just want to take the critical levels from this daily engulfing fail. So having these two will lower the risk, like I said. Okay.
So this is the green zone. If we want to even look for a cell, we wait for something in here rather than selling somewhere in the middle, correct? Because 90% of the time, if you go wrong, it's gonna really push the price in the opposite direction. So this is the first zone for a cell. So let me put the color as purple. Now, what if this zone fails? Maybe there's a confirmation buy in here and then it wants to break out. You know, if this zone is a breakout, it is a daily zone. So you don't bother going to H1 looking for the lower time frame here and there, because you want the ultra safest zones, right? You go to the place whereby there was a strong breakout that happened over here. Engulfing buy that was broken, boom, boom, boom. Drop. Every time it tried to go up, boom, price drops. Every time it tries to go up, boom, price drops. So historically, there's something over here that is really strong. So how do we obtain that specific price point? We go back and study this area. So we know that at this area, there was an engulfing cell that was broken. After it broke, it left an engulfing buy. From this point, it flew like fuck, crazily. So there's something in this price level that can potentially give us crazy motherfucking shit. So we take this level first. Okay. Now, you have two buys and two sells. So these are your low risk zones of the day. For example, if you were to make a mistake in the black zone, what you will do is recovery must be done in these boxes only. So the black zone is a dangerous zone because there's no evidential bigger time frame prices. There's only M15, H4, H1. So we can trade those. But the point is, if we do take a loss, where do we recover? In the zones. So now, because back in the day, I will tell people, don't trade in the black zone, no trade zone, because you guys were newbies. But after being 6 months with me, I assume that you guys have learned from every single drop of my knowledge I have dropped for free all the fucking time, no charges, okay? Because that's just how I am. You guys must have learned that there are ways you can trade in here, blah blah blah. So now I'm gonna tell you, you guys can trade in the black zone, but if it goes wrong, you don't counter your position or your move in here again. Why risk? You wait for the probable zone to recover losses. But if you make a win in here, you stop. Because sometimes the overexcitement will make you want to push yourself to trade more. So what you do then is wait in the zone to fulfill your excitement. So it's not wrong to be excited. It's wrong to be excited for no reason. So therefore, now your mind for the day is at ease, correct? You're not stressed. You can go to work. You can take care of your kid. So don't make it an excuse that whereby you cannot be a full-time trader while having a normal life. You can, if you know how to manage your positions well in a day. So after achieving this, we just relax and breathe and look at all the price range that we are targeting for today. So then you take a piece of paper, a book, an iPad, whatever equipment or device that you have, it doesn't matter. It is the ritual that matters. This is how I do it all the time back in the day when I was a newbie. I would write, "Dear self, today I have marked 3 potential pairs that I would classify as a low risk, high reward trade. So checklist of the day. For example, we just marked for gold. So we have to fulfill the peaceness by writing it down. So we execute the plan. You want to be professional, so treat this professionally. So zone number 1 is 1835 until 1830. So we write that down first. Doesn't matter. Don't think this is useless. 1835. 1830. What is the action that we potentially want to do there? Maybe buy. Doesn't mean it comes, we buy. It comes, we wait for confirmation. If there is, we buy. Second zone is 1809 1815. 1870 1879. And last but not least, 1906 1899. Sell. So when we have this checklist of the day, we know that we want to try and check. For example, we take the trade, and then later on we do a result of it. Success. Fail, and etc. etc. And then imagine if you want to trade 3 pairs today, you have to do this for all the pairs. That's why prep your mind for the pairs. So now we have goal sorted, and then now we classify the directions that we see visually. For example, goal, we go to H4. We can see right now the direction is a sell for H4 sell. Daily, for now it's a sell, but it can be a reversal buy if it drops until here. But as of the price we are speaking of right now, daily looks more like a sell, but it can have a retracement up. So we say sell, potential retracement up. So let's say if we suddenly feel like buying, then we just understand if it buys and it just wants to retrace, until where should we stop buying? You know, it's never wrong to buy or sell. And then weekly, we look at it. Weekly is evidently sell. So now, when you look at the odds, H4, sell. Daily, looks like a sell. Weekly, sell. So you know, better for you to risk your money in selling. But be careful of the retracement of daily, because we saw that it can potentially retrace. So tell me, if you have all this sorted in a day, can you lose as bad? You can't. You guys are losing because you guys are gambling following motherfuckers who are throwing out 20 signals a day, and then the only thing they say is add layer, and then suddenly running 10 pips from layer, and then they put their daily result as all green and win. Holy shit. And then you guys like that because you think it's high intensity trading. That is high intensity stupidity. Don't do that. So I hope this can guide you. I want you guys to do this. Do it for all the other pairs. Tomorrow I will do GJ and Euro JPY for you guys to update as well, and then we see how it goes, because I am not going to focus on signals. I'm going to focus on guiding you through all the signals that were given, if it was given. Okay, thank you for the first episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like and share and subscribe. Make me the number one in YouTube for Forex. Let's go, international baby.